In the chess game that is politics, morality can seem like a moving target.
You need to draw a line in the sand and say none of it is okay.
If that was the case, why did it take 7 accusers to unite Democratic senators in calling for Senator Franken's resignation?
I do think that Democrats are trying to make a statement that none of this should be acceptable. But the reality was it was a hard argument for them to make while Franken was still serving.
Democratic leaders were quick to call for some resignations, like Nevada Representative Reuben Kuhn, but much slower to call for others, Michigan's John Conyers. Republicans in Congress have shown similar inconsistencies. In October, House Speaker Paul Ryan quickly asked for Congressman Tim Murphy to step down. Murphy accused of trying to have his alleged mistress get an abortion. But last week, when Representative Blake Farenthold was found to have used taxpayer dollars to settle a sexual harassment claim, no pressure from the top to resign. Not to mention the president condemning Franken while supporting Senate candidate Roy Moore, accused of sexually assaulting a minor 40 years ago.
He totally denies it. He says it didn't happen.
So why call for Franken to step down now?
The answer boils down to the seriousness of the allegations, the number of allegations, and sort of the partisan bias in people's reactions.
Political science professor Catherine Pearson says it would be hard for Democrats to condemn the allegations against Roy Moore without doing the same against Franken. Another common question plastered all over social media today: why the resignation calls for Franken but not President Trump, despite his 16 accusers? Two common rebuttals by Republicans. Voters knew about Trump's accusations before the election, and Trump has consistently denied every one of his allegations.
Right, interesting.